You ready to get a bit emotional?
I'm already jumping the gun.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, Cristiano Ronaldo, in a photograph on his Instagram alongside Gonzalo Higuain and the likes of Cuadrado and Douglas Costa, both players with their thumbs up, looking all happy. That is the closest Cristiano will be alongside Higuain on a pitch this season.
You have a pretty good point. And when you take a look at that photo, I mean, these are guys that have played together in the past. There is some history between them. They might have just been, you know, chatting about pleasant days in Madrid. But I have a feeling it was a little bit more the feeling that Gonzalo Higuain had when he heard that Cristiano Ronaldo was going to be coming to town. And a little bit of a scream in the night for Gonzalo. He's a great player. Yeah. The goals went down a little bit, but that might have had more to do with the system. And if the reports are true that he could be going to Milan, I have a feeling that he'll do quite well there.
Yeah, it seems to be set. Gonzalo Higuain readying for a move to Milan very soon indeed. Major League Soccer All-Star Game taking on the old lady Juventus this evening at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta. I say, Phil Schoen, go back to the East versus West. There's enough talent throughout. Get rid of these sides coming over like Juventus that don't have Ronaldo, that don't have Higuain, that don't have Cuadrado and Douglas Costa. They're rolling out their young kids. Get back and have the Major League Soccer go at each other.
Well, there's a great point there in the fact that half the All-Stars don't even get a chance to play, just the way the system is set up. And I think it would be a much more entertaining game in itself. But there's one reason MLS is sticking with this, and that's the simple fact that if you end up playing East versus West, North versus South, shirts versus skins, well, maybe that one might work in some regards. But when you take a look at that, you're preaching to the converted, and you bring in the likes of a Manchester United, you bring in the likes of a Juventus, you bring in a Barcelona perhaps, or even a Chivas, etc. There are fans of those teams that don't watch MLS that you have the chance to bring and increase the pie. So again, it comes down to money. It is entertaining. They might be saying it's spring training, it's preseason, if you will. But from an MLS perspective, every one of those wins that they get over a European or an international power is one more notch in the belt.
You know, though, credit to Atlanta. When you look at the All-Star Game in Chicago last year, the city wasn't captured by the event. This year in Atlanta, everybody knows All-Star.
Packed house.
It's happening. 72,000 people expected at Mercedes-Benz Stadium this evening. And I think that's a clear sign, if ever there was one, that Major League Soccer is certainly on the rise in this country and certainly in Atlanta. Our final one of the evening then for you, Phil Schoen. Barcelona haven't got a clue what they're doing. They don't know what they're doing in their transfer window. What are they up to? Roma about to sign Malcolm. They say, oh, Monchi's going to go for him. Let's go and get him. They already have Ousmane Dembele. Luka Digne is gone. He's the only substitute at left back. What are they doing?
Well, in my mind, a big heaping scoop of chocolate ice cream or whatever, because Barcelona is still one of the best teams on earth.
And that was the chocolate ice cream for my comment.
It was.
Okay.
Because in my mind, you take a look at Dembele, injuries, flashes. Malcolm already in one game has given Barcelona fans something to cheer about. The fact that he is a little bit more direct, a little bit more of a goal-scoring threat, that Dembele did not prove to be last year. He's a little bit more experienced as well. So I think from that perspective, absolutely. Digne had the chance for 3 years to earn that spot against Jordi Alba, even under Luis Enrique, when Luis Enrique was not a huge Jordi Alba fan. So he was unable to do so. I have a feeling, again, this is a reworking, maybe because Messi's getting up there just a little bit, Busquets as well, a reworking of the Barcelona system, they're going to be fine.
Okay. Phil Schoen, thank you so much for the time.